Hey everybody, I'm Billy with Waldoch, and we are a preferred upfitter for Ford, GM, and Ram, building lifted trucks and custom vans since 1974. I'm going to show you today a Moto-Van that has a somewhat living quarters, travel quarters in the front, and then a garage in the back. Right here, we're going to just talk about the exterior factory features right now. This has a xenon headlights. We have all the safety features that you can get from Ford on this van as well. All-wheel drive. This also is a 3.5 EcoBoost, which you get enough power to get wherever you're going in to tow, close up to 7,000 pounds. The size of this van is a 148 EL high roof. So that's the largest van that Ford produces. And on the outside, Waldoch has done is the awning on the outside. We have security lights on both sides that you can turn the lights on. That's for hauling anything you need in the garage, which we'll get to that point back there. You can see the water fill tank. We have a 40-gallon water tank underneath that you can fill up to wash anything that you'll see in the back trunk area. Now we'll step inside. I'm gonna open up the awning here. And you can open up this awning with one person, two people. It's nice. It has two legs that I'll show you that you can pull out so it holds it up. There, got the awning all set. And then come on inside. This is a 5-passenger, 3 seats back here, 2 seats up front. This folds out into a bed. So you just gotta grab the underneath here and you pull this down and it folds out. You know, sleeping isn't the biggest. You can swivel these chairs around, make it a little bit bigger if you're gonna be sleeping. There's also storage underneath. So you have plenty of storage that you can stick things underneath there as well. Makes it really nice. The sheet covers that up. Now this is the fan up above. So if you are sleeping, it has adjustments where you can change the different temperature in the room to try to keep it at temperature. Sucks air in, sucks air out. Really nice feature, especially if you're camping. Not meant to be driving down the road with it on and working, but you can also do that. If you look up on the top, we have storage up above on both. And you can see the surround sound for the speakers. This one does not have a TV, but you can get that option to have a flip-down TV right here. This just has the audio system. And if you step over here, you can see the audio setup. So this has HDMI, this has USB, you have your aux, you have your Bluetooth. So if you wanted to play something, you can just literally play the, and you can turn it up right with your phone. I have an iPhone that I'm using right now, but you can adjust it that easily right with your phone. You don't have to adjust it here. You can turn it all the way up, and then it has different settings that you can set however you'd like, but it's really nice so you can walk outside and be adjusting the speakers and setup. And there's two different audio systems. This is the front, and then there's an audio system in the rear that I'll show you as well. You have your 12-volt receptacle there. You have 110 right here to plug in, and then you have 110 over on the corner here to plug in as well. So that's for the outdoor. If you're doing something underneath the awning, you have your 110 right there. All right, on both of our windows, the driver window and then the sliding window, we have manual shades that you can pull down. Blocks out the sun, blocks out the heat, and then it's nice for, you know, some privacy at night if you're actually sleeping in it. Cup holders that are right here. I can turn on the mood light. You can see up top, I just turned on the mood light. The cup holders are blue lights, and then you have a light here in your storage compartment as well. So it just sets the mood if you're traveling and driving. It's a really nice feature. We'll talk about up front, but there's a nice little cooler that you can have when you're traveling. And now we'll step in the back and take a look at the garage. All right, everybody, I'm showing you the shore power hookup that we have. It's a smart plug. That's what it looks like. This is what the receptacle looks like. This is super nice. So if you do have a power outage, this actually just gets disconnected automatically if there's a power shortage. You have this end, this can change over to a 110 plug or any camper setup that you have as well. We're back in the cargo area, garage area. So over here on the side here, I just wanna go over this really quick, all the different components. We have the switch, which is the same in the front. You have your own right here, so you can suck the fumes out, or you can have it really cool if you're working in the garage. This is your rear radio. Two separate systems again. You have the front and you have the back. These are all your light switches for all the different lights that are inside. There's a ton of lights. This is for security. There's also two security lights on the outside that we'll show you that you turn on. This is for loading, if you're loading at night or anything like that. It lights up everywhere around the van. Super nice. This is for your inverter, your power inverter. This is for the cabinet lights. There's cabinet light switches on every cabinet. So when you open it up, the cabinet lights up. So you have your own switches for the cabinet lights. Down here below, this is your water for your fresh water for washing. This is your hose. You literally connect this pretty quickly. And obviously I'd never do it right, you know, when you're on camera, but you can just change it. Change the different soaks. Whatever you need to do, you need to shower off, you need to wash your bike, whatever it needs. That is literally right on this back corner, the pump for it as well. So you can disconnect that. Talk about the electronics. Over here, this is your 110 power. So when you're on shore power, these need to be on. Right now we're using 12 volt, the van's running, so it's powering the inverter. You have your 110, you have your 12 volt. This is the master switch for all the 12 volt. So literally you turn this sideways, it shuts off all the 12 volt that's in the van. Now you step over into here, this is your control center. These are all your fuses. All of them are labeled for everything that's in the van. This is your lithium battery, go power, and this is your 3000 watt inverter that's on it. This is basically the whole system that runs the van. So you could be using everything in the van when the van's running, or you can be hooked up to shore power, or you could just be running off the battery for a amount of time as well. So we built it for every type of scenario. If you're out at a track, or if you want to take it camping, if you want to go to your cabin, anything you want to do, it's literally meant to be a garage, indoor garage, to be able to take anywhere. And looking at the cabinets, you know, they're built all aluminum, really nice and strong. All the speakers that are in here are all marine grade. So we put a smoke detector and carbon monoxide detector in here and in the front, just for safety if you're sleeping, or if you ever did want to sleep in the garage as well. So I want to talk about the flooring. All these tracks that are in the system, there's a number of different components for bicycles, dirt bikes, motorcycles that actually clip in. This is actually strength. This is tied into the frame of the body, which this van doesn't have a frame, but it's a unibody, but we have plates underneath holding this. So it'll hold a, you know, 250, 300 pound motorcycle on the inside. We also sealed everything on the inside. So literally you can have water all the way around. All we did with the black sealing in there and the tie down straps that we have up above. And then we put the diamond plate in just for the durability of everything. If you're throwing things in, so it's not gonna scratch the walls. And this front wall is a sealed wall. You can also put wheel chocks up against this. This is thick enough to some certain models, if they want to, you can put a wheel chalk in to have it mount here, but you also can have the tie downs that go right to your foot pegs to hold it down as well. You can put motorcycles forward and backwards, so you can fit a number of motorcycles inside the garage area that you might need. You know, obviously different size motorcycles are gonna be fit differently, but we try to utilize the space as best as possible. All right, guys, we're just gonna talk about the back end real quick. Talked about it earlier. This does have a factory hitch with the factory wiring hookup, the four, and then the big prong. It does have trailer brakes. It's about 7,000, 7,500 pounds with the gear setup we have with this EcoBoost on this van. This is also an all-wheel drive. The backup camera is up here, so it has a good wide view. Screen's nice and big. Really nice screen on the 22 Ford Transit. One thing I did forget, our Waldoch job bag, all the owner's manuals, all the extra components that go inside of it. Can't miss it, it's red. So this has a first aid kit, all the different owner's manuals that come with it, all the different components for the awning, some manual setup. So like if the power isn't working, you can manually expand it out. That comes in your job bag. And also over here on the passenger, it does come with two USB charging ports that I did forget to mention. The nice storage compartments in the back of the seat. They are upgraded leather seats, just like our Galaxy van package as well. Now we'll head up front. All right, everybody, I'm up in the cockpit now. I'm just gonna talk about some of the Waldoch features and the factory features. Waldoch features, we have our blue light switch up front here, and then all the other auxiliary are open for any other components. We have our cooler up front here. Right now it's set to 12 degrees, so it's basically like almost like a freezer slash refrigerator right now. It's pretty close to a freezer. Now all the Ford factory features. We have power folding mirrors. The folding mirrors fold in. You have all your cruise control and adaptive cruise set up on the steering wheel, so that's really nice. We have our big screen, so you have Apple CarPlay with the USB. This is plugging in the cooler setup. This also can be moved into the back as well if you wanted to. Right now it's wedged in between the seats, which it stays put. You can put coolers and or drinks inside of it, whatever you need. Also the backup camera that I mentioned before, you can see it has the nice screenshot of the actual van of what you could be hitting, and then the backup section as well. This has changed in 22 on this big screen. Is the air controls used to be down here. Now they're on the screen. They're digital. You can set it up for different, how you want it to come in to the air. Really pretty cool looking on how it works. The max air, you can set that up. You have your heated mirrors, you have your AC, and then you have your fan speed over here. It works the same way as your cool and everything like that, that I was just showing you with the low. You have your auto, come back to the home screen if you just wait. You have all your settings here that you can change. So if you've had a Ford product, very similar on how it's all set up, all your features, the different drive modes that you can go on to, eco, slip, tow haul, mud rut. Little different from when they used to just have a little button here, but you also can hit that right here. So one button is for the mud rut. Then you do have your air conditioning for, you know, I just put the heat on, so this is for heating. We don't want to burn ourselves out here. This one's the camera, so if you want to watch, look at the quick front view camera and then overview of it, you just hit the camera button right here. And then this is for your park assist button as well, and then your hazards. And the brake controller is down here. I talked about it a little bit, but it has a brake controller for the factory hitch. All right, everybody, now it's the end of the video. Now's my, you know, you need to subscribe to us if you want to see a new video. But really, we do have a new van coming out, so if you do subscribe, you're going to see our new rec van, which is basically like this moto van, except right here in the back is a camper setup with a sink, a refrigerator, a little bed. Both chairs swivel around, but it's really cool. It's basically like a camper in the front, so really living quarters and a garage in the back. But thanks for joining me, and catch me on the next video.